reported today in The Verge. CBS is planning an improved streaming service after squandering its head start with All Access. ViacomCBS is launching a new streaming service that will hopefully do more for the recently merged company than the current form of CBS All Access has done in its six-year run. The new service will build upon CBS All Access, which costs $5.99 per month with ads or $9.99 a month without, by offering an assortment of Viacom networks to customers. The company announced its expansive approach to streaming, which ViacomCBS referred to in a press release as House of Brands. Part of the company's goals to accelerate its presence in the streaming space is to take a differentiated approach that builds on ViacomCBS' unique foundation in streaming, plays to its strengths. This includes offering live sports and news, similar to what NBCUniversal is doing with Peacock. New broad pay House of Brands product will expand CBS All Access by adding the company's scaled assets in film and TV, including world-renowned brands, and reaffirm and expand the value of entertainment, news and sports, through on-demand and live experiences, for audiences around the world, a press release reads. The goal is to complement services such as Pluto TV, Free, and Showtime's premium offerings by adding a broad pay offering, built on the foundation of CBS All Access. Details are still extremely thin, including how much the different tiers will cost. More information is expected on the company's earnings call with investors. The new service is only a possibility now, thanks to the merger between CBS and Viacom. Networks and studios like BET, Comedy Central, MTV, Nickelodeon, and Paramount Pictures didn't fully belong to CBS prior to the network and Viacom rejoining last year. The new service will also give subscribers access to Pluto TV, a free ad-supported virtual TV service Viacom purchased before the CBS merger that offers customers programming from specialized channels. Most notably, Pluto offers access to limited versions of NBC News, Spike TV, MTV, The Movie Channel, CBS News, and CNN. CBS was one of the earliest entrants in the streaming wars. The company launched All Access in October 2014. 7 years after Netflix launched its streaming service and 5 years before Disney, Apple, NBCUniversal, and Warner Media got into the game. While CBS was early, All Access never became the streaming juggernaut the company hoped it would. All Access and Showtime's standalone streaming services hit a combined 10 million subscribers in January 2020, up 2 million combined from the year before. Yet, while 10 million isn't anything to scoff at, CBS All Access has fewer customers than HBO Now. It also trails Disney Plus' 28 million subscribers the company amassed within just the first 3 months of its launch, and All Access is still short of Hulu's 30. For more on this story, visit the news article link.